Joe, we're back again. This is the fifth installment of the All Night Long Wrestling Podcast.
We're back and we're not going anywhere.
I hope not. I don't have much else to do in my life. I got a podcast, Joe. I got a podcast and I got the Four Horsemen.
What else do we need?
That's all we need at the end of the day. There's a lot going on right now. There's a lot going on this week and there's a lot that we didn't talk about last week. So I feel like we should pick up right where we left off.
All about the world of professional wrestling? Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, there was NXT had a special last week.
Correct.
Yep. 2-hour special last Wednesday. Then there was a Monday Night Raw last night, obviously. We're doing this on a Tuesday, so Raw was last night.
Right.
I know you want to get to that. Because
I can't wait to talk about Monday Night Raw.
That's all you've been talking about since
I can't
last
stop.
Night is Monday Night Raw.
Like a kid on Christmas Eve, Joe. I can't stop talking
I don't know
about
if
Raw.
if you heard this on the show last night. I don't know if they mentioned it. But it was the last Raw from Nassau Coliseum last night. I don't know if they said it. I don't remember. I don't know if they brought that up. Do you remember if they brought that up?
I did watch it. I don't remember if they said it was the last Raw, but I have a stupid question. I'm in New York. I'm a Long Islander. So are they closing the Nassau Coliseum?
Well, I think they're shutting it down, doing some renovations.
Okay.
And I think they're supposed to reopen it under like a new, you know, format or whatever. Maybe
gotcha.
Less
so
seats.
It'll be the last Raw at the Nassau Coliseum where there are no seats in the last row because all the Islander fans ripped out the seats.
If you listen to Michael Cole last night, the whole building's getting torn down. So
I don't want to talk about Michael Cole. I want to talk about NXT. Let's start with NXT and work our
all
way
right.
forward.
NXT.
Last week was the NXT special takeover?
Yeah, it was an NXT takeover special last
Wednesday.
Takeover.
It was the pay-per-view. That's not a pay-per-view. Yeah. It's a big event.
They're equivalent of it, right?
I enjoyed it top to bottom. Where do you want to go? You want to go main event?
Yeah, let's you can start that.
Let's start at the top and just talk about what you liked. I thought it was the right time for Enzo and Big Cass to win the NXT tag titles.
So you were disappointed? When
I was disappointed that Blue Pants. I'm sorry, not Blue Pants.
Alexa Bliss.
Alexa Bliss. I would have liked the Blue Pants. A little continuity.
Blue Pants running would have been clutch.
Yeah,
I feel like.
Yeah.
But
we want Blue Pants. That was a great chant.
Yeah. That's, but yeah, so Alexa Bliss came out and helped Blake and Murphy retain the tag titles over Enzo and Cass. I think the speculation was that Carmella might turn on Enzo and Cass, but that did not happen. So Alexa Bliss, I guess, turned.
Finally keeping a tag team together for more than a year or so, pointing to the Real Americans.
Oh, you missed the Real Americans, man.
You
just like Cesaro.
I like Cesaro and I like Jack Swagger's haircut.
That's fair.
But I was happy to see Enzo in the ring. Every time I see Enzo in the ring, he's getting ragdolled and super kicked. And he's cutting a great promo before and he's cutting a great promo after. But he looks better in the ring. It looks like he's working.
I like those guys, man. I mean, they cut good promos. They have good interviews. They're entertaining, I think, especially for the crowd. The crowd loves them. Wrestling-wise, they're not. I don't think they're bad in any way. So, like, I don't see why, you know, you wouldn't. If you were a company, why you wouldn't want to push them if they're so popular, you know?
The way I look at it, Enzo and Big Cass, there's a guy there. He's got all the looks. He's got a bright future. He's got big biceps. And then there's the other guy who could talk on the mic and do nothing else. I'm the do nothing else guy, and you're the big biceps.
That seems inaccurate. I don't know where that comes from.
I've seen you in a t-shirt. I know what goes on under
there.
It's
a good thing this is on audio and not video because
unlucky for you, I actually uploaded 6 Instagram photos of you curling 138 pounds today.
Where'd you get your hands on those?
I'm really good at doing creepy things.
Sneaky pick.
Sneaky pick. I remember that app. Let's get back to Enzo. They're so over everywhere they go. The entire crowd is going crazy.
Yeah, they got a new t-shirt, right? Coming out, the new t-shirt.
They do have a new t-shirt, Enzo's Instagram showed Mick Foley wearing it. So Mick Foley is a fan of Enzo and Big Cass.
Yeah, well, yeah, they I think they do a good job. So,
but why would you keep the titles on Blake and Murphy? What do they bring to the table?
Maybe it's just a long-term thing, man. Maybe they're doing like a long-term program. I'm sure they're going to do some like 6-person, you know, mixed tags with Alexa Bliss, with Blake and Murphy, and then with Carmella. With Enzo and Cass. So they're probably going to do that for a little while, maybe stretch it out. And then the next time they do a takeover, which will probably be in a couple months, maybe they'll do a rematch or something like that. I mean, that's the one thing you can hope for.
Everybody else that's in the tag division at NXT is getting brought up to the main stage. So I think the time.
Because the Ascension, that was a big
thing. Works so well. Now they're feuding with the Lucha Dragons, which is strange.
You're
because
a big fan.
They did that in NXT.
You love the Ascension, right?
I do. God, I can't get enough of the Ascension. Okay. It's not that I have anything wrong with Blake. You know, I don't take issue with Blake and Murphy, but they're not doing anything with them. Their gimmick is like they come out and it's like a rave almost, and they look identical.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess they're still developing their personality, you could say. I don't know why they decided to
put the titles
on them.
I probably would have developed them before I put the tag titles on.
Yeah, maybe they just, I think we talked about this once before, maybe that they needed to, the Lucha Dragons were going up to the main roster, so they needed to put it on somebody, and maybe they felt like they'll put it on these guys, let them run as heels for a little while, and then maybe Enzo and Cass get it from them in a few months. That's just, I mean, I don't know if that's what they're doing, but like you said, they're the tag teams. You want to try to keep tag teams together and build programs, so it seems like that might be the direction to go, but I don't.
Well, we call you the booker for a reason. Mm-hmm. So if you're saying the long-term goal here is to get Enzo and Big Cass with a big, big title win,
yeah,
I'm all for it.
Hey.
Let's get past that. Let's go to the first match of the night, which was Tyler Breeze.
And Finn Balor, I think, yeah.
Yeah, Tyler Breeze and Finn Balor. And it should have been a day with Tommy, but Tommy got they ran that the angle with the Tommy.
Yeah, the shoulder injury, right? Yep. Which they didn't tell anybody about beforehand, and they ran an angle before the show where like he was beat up in the parking lot or something like that, and he couldn't make the triple threat. So they switch it to Breeze versus Balor one-on-one for the number one contender spot.
I don't want to say it's sloppy booking, but everybody knew 2 weeks ahead of time that Tommy wasn't going
to
be able to get
it. It was weird. They were trying to keep the kayfabe on that one. But, I mean, it is what it is.
You can't pick and choose when you want to, you know, yeah. Go all kayfabe.
It seems like NXT is maybe more geared towards that, whereas like WWE is like, oh, let's put it on Twitter and our app and all this type of stuff and make sure we get
people.
What
was that video thing they had? Tout. You
can
tout to WWE. That worked out really well for him.
You filmed a lot of touts, let's be honest.
I did. I
touted. Let's not lie to anybody.
I did. I touted to Dolph Ziggler all the time. He got back to me twice.
Did he?
Nope. None of that. None of that was legitimate. That was a straight fabrication on my part. Yeah. Tyler Breeze, what do you think?
He's fine, I think, but I don't know. Like, he's an entertaining guy. He's not he's a good wrestler or whatever. I feel like I don't know where he's going to go long term, especially if he makes it to their main roster. Like, I don't see where. He's kind of got this look. He looks like Ziggler to me a little bit. He's actually kind of smaller. He's got like the Zoolander model gimmick, which is fine. I think it's a cool thing. But
I've been waiting for the WWE shop to carry the Tyler Breeze selfie stick because I've got little baby T-Rex arms and I can't get myself in full angle. Mm-hmm. So if we could get a selfie stick, Joe, that would have made this trip a lot easier.
Sounds like a moneymaker.
Yeah, well, book it. His finisher. I'm gonna talk about it every week until somebody changes it. If Rusev can start a match with Tyler Breeze's finisher and not get a three count, there's no way that he should legitimately use that move as a finisher.
So you don't like the beauty shot?
I don't like the beauty shot. Okay. Get rid of anything. I'd rather body slam. A hard hammer lock. Anything. Tyler Breeze is listening. At NY Enforcer on Twitter. Tweet me. I've got ideas for you, Tyler Breeze. Just the Divas match? Can you call them NXT Divas? What do we call them?
Well, I mean, whatever that match.
You know what? Let's call them professional wrestlers because that was a great wrestling match.
Yeah. Sasha Banks and Becky Lynch. It's interesting, I guess. You know, they've really developed a lot of good women's wrestlers in NXT. And not to say that the Divas on the main roster are bad because I don't want to disparage anybody, but I just think the NXT.
They don't have a chance. They don't have the chance. There were two, the NXT special was 2 hours long, correct?
Yes.
And there were two quote unquote Divas matches. And those matches blew everything on Raw away.
Yeah. Yeah, and they're, I mean, I don't want to get too insider on stuff, but I think it's Sarah Del Rey and is one of the trainers down there. And if she's the one
responsible. Mrs. Antonio Cesaro.
Yeah, if she's the one that's responsible for training the women, then I think she deserves a lot of credit because obviously in addition to the women wrestlers. But, you know, I think that's, you know, something that they're doing really well down there.
I think I was thinking about sending a video into Tough Enough. I've cut some promos in my day. I don't have the look. Apparently, a 5'6" underachiever doesn't really sell tickets.
That's exactly
but I can,
the look they're looking for.
That's the look. I'm Adrian Neville then. But I, speaking of Sarah Del Rey, I think she's one of the trainers on Tough Enough.
Yes.
Did I make that up?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe.
I think she's one of the trainers.
I think Billy Gunn is actually a trainer. So
badass seems... Billy Gunn. Yeah. Let's just finish up with NXT. Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens versus Sami Zayn in main event. What'd you think? You've seen how many Kevin Owens, Kevin Steen, Sami Zayn, El Generico matches in your life?
Yeah.
Five, six, seven?
A dozen, probably, I guess.
Where do you put this one?
I mean, somewhere in the middle. I mean, it wasn't really, I think the purpose of the match was really more of an angle, right? I mean, the whole thing was they didn't even have a finish, right? He just kind of beat up Zayn at the end and threw him on their apron on the outside. And then the end of the whole thing was that he couldn't continue or whatever happened. And then, you know, Samoa Joe debuted at the end.
I was leading up to this.
Did I jump the gun on that?
You jumped the gun. You opened my presents on Christmas Eve.
Okay.
But it's okay. Samoa Joe versus Kevin Owens. They taped it. I don't want to talk about it. I didn't watch the NXT tapings. But having Samoa Joe walk out in NXT, I thought was awesome.
Yeah, I thought that was awesome. And you know, one of the things that's interesting about him, again, is that it seems like his contract is not exclusive to WWE because he's still working dates with other companies like indie shows and ROH as
they,
well.
They just announced today he's going to be at the ROH Best in the World Aftershock TV taping.
Yeah.
We're live here, so this is a shoot, but if one more person texts me about how awesome Raw was last night when I wasn't there, I'm going to get pretty upset about it. I got, the live crowd was awesome last night. Oh my God, this crowd is crazy.
So you're bitter.
I'm a bitter old man at the age of 28, Joe. Let's talk about Raw real quick.
Well, it's all you've been talking about since it ended last night, so I don't know why you want to go through it quickly.
I can't get enough of it. Kyle just texted me and he said, Owens is crazy over with the live crowd. So let's talk about Kevin Owens, because I probably enjoyed that more than anything else on Raw.
So I guess with Owens, obviously, I mean, for anybody who watches, right, he's getting into an angle with John Cena. And he's going to be wrestling John Cena at Elimination Chamber this coming Sunday night.
Yep.
So the last 2 weeks, he's come out during, I think the first time was during John Cena promo.
Yep.
And then this week, after John Cena's match, and attacked him and got the better of Cena at the end of the segment. So what are the chances?
You have an issue with this.
No,
we talked about it. It's a little bit of foreshadowing.
Well, I guess the thing is, what are the odds now? Because I think there should be no other option than him winning clean on Sunday night.
He's destroyed him 2 weeks in a row. He's obviously the better wrestler. He got much better promos on him.
Right.
Why are we going to have John Cena win next week?
Yeah, I don't see what good it does anybody if John Cena beats him, like, even, I mean, in any fashion. Like, I don't get what the point of it would be. So
caveat,
I think,
is it's a non-title match. Yep. So it's possible Kevin Owens could go over clean, destroy John Cena, and not win the title.
It sounds perfect.
In a perfect world.
Write it down.
Right. Book it.
There's no reason. I just don't see why, what benefit it would be to anybody for John Cena to beat him. Because Owens has, you know, pretty good momentum right now.
He's got a good following.
Right? He's kind of on fire as far as everything he's doing, right? His promos, matches, like you said. They're putting him into a program with the biggest star that they have, really on 2 weeks' notice, but they're doing
but
it anyway.
Look how over he is with the crowd.
Yeah.
Last 2 weeks ago, it took him a little while to warm up and they get the fight Owens fight chant. And then this week when Owens came out, it was awesome. It was off the charts. So
I mean, I don't see like where there would be any reason not to have Owens win. Like, why? Like, can you conceivably come up with a reason why they wouldn't have Owens win this match other than Vince McMahon?
No, because I know Triple H is all about, you know, the NXT guys is all about Kevin Owens, and I know John Cena is a big Kevin Owens fan as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, does John Cena do the job for him? He could, because it's a non-title match.
Yeah, I mean, I think it would. I mean, that would be ideally, that's what you would want, right? Like, he puts him over, you know, basically then 2 seconds.
He's put over all the other guys from NXT, and he's had competitive matches with him. He's put over, no, he hasn't put him over, but he's beaten him. He's beat Adrian Neville. I'm sorry, he's beaten Neville. Mm-hmm. He's beat Zayn. He beat Zack Ryder. But none of those guys are the champion, and he has very competitive matches with him.
Yeah.
I'm not a doctor. I didn't go to school for professional wrestling. God, I would have if I had a choice. But I think it's the time to put Kevin Owens over. Make it a tough match. If you want him, he's a heel. Make him win dirty.
Yeah.
Have a low blow and into a package driver or a pop-up powerbomb. Whatever it takes to get Kevin Owens' hand raised on Sunday.
Yeah. There's no other option.
Well, there's plenty of other options. No. Me leaving disappointed.
Well, that happens most of their shows.
Par for the course. Yeah. But the rest of Raw, Seth Rollins. Are you tired of Seth Rollins? Be honest. I want you to be honest with me and tell me you're tired of Seth Rollins.
I like Seth Rollins. I do.
Caveat. Sounds like there's a butt coming.
There's a lot of Seth Rollins on the show every week. A lot of times that includes other members of the Authority. Of which I don't think.
Let's
I
get
like.
Some more Kane, huh?
No,
more Kane. Okay.
I was just gonna say I don't think there's anybody else in the Authority that I want to see on TV besides Seth Rollins. Can you think of anybody?
I would watch Jamie Noble wrestle. I still like Jamie Noble.
Yeah. I mean, they're fine. I mean,
was Randy Orton on TV last night?
Not that I saw.
But he did wrestle in the dark match.
Yes, he wrestled in the dark match. I think he fought Bray Wyatt in a dark match after the show ended.
Was Bray Wyatt on TV last night?
Not that I saw either. Makes a lot of sense.
I mean, you want to give the Long Island crowd for their last show, fine, but you want Bray Wyatt on TV. You want Randy Orton on TV.
His brother, Bo Dallas, is getting a pay-per-view match, so you can't have both on the pay-per-view at once, right? Is that the rule?
That's true. Although the Neville versus Bo Dallas match we saw in NXT a year and a half ago, it was awesome, so I'm all for it.
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah.
Just doesn't seem like to me they really know what to do with Bray Wyatt again.
They don't. They seem to start and stop a lot on his angles and stuff like that. Like, he had, you know, long feuds with Ambrose, and then he went into the Undertaker one earlier this year.
I have an idea, and you're going to hate it, but you have to hear me out.
You're going
to
tell me anyway.
I've known you like 11 years. I think you need to trust me.
Okay.
Let's put the mask back on Kane, and let's have him feud with Bray Wyatt and have Bray Wyatt go over. Do we hate it?
I don't hate it.
Yes. Knew it.
I just, the only thing is about with Kane is that obviously I crap on Kane a
corporate
lot.
Corporate Kane,
so
yeah, correct.
I'm tired of it. It's just, how many times is he going to go back and forth with the mask and not with the mask? Like, I'm kind of, I just watched him wrestle in slacks for the last 6 months.
He did.
So why do I have to?
He wrestled in slacks.
Now he's going to put on like a spandex suit and a
Kane's
mask.
Kane's like 48 years old and he doesn't wear a t-shirt ever. The guy's in great shape. I would never wear a t-shirt if I was Kane. But maybe Bray Wyatt brings something out of him. You know, he could do whatever happened to the Bray Wyatt Ryback. Is that over? Is that done?
That's right. Yeah, they did like a one match feud at the last pay-per-view, which was Payback, I think.
Right.
Wyatt won.
Mm-hmm.
And then they split him off. I think Ryback's in the Intercontinental title match at pay-per-view on Sunday, Elimination Chamber.
Okay.
The sixth person. And Wyatt has no match.
All right.
We have Bo Dallas.
We do. So. We have Bo Dallas. And while we're talking about Raw, I think Johnny Drama has a future in the WWE. I think I enjoyed the guys from Entourage there more than I did at anything.
I thought they did good. Yeah, I mean, we like those guys to begin with, but I thought they did good.
When Johnny Drama jumped in the ring, I thought that was good
TV.
Your
favorite part, I think, was when Turtle brought up Ronda Rousey to Stephanie in the back.
Right? I love Ronda. Can't get enough of Ronda Rousey. Oh. Ronda, don't call me Nick Diaz Rousey.
Is that an inside MMA term?
That's an inside MMA term. But I can't. I don't want to get into Ronda Rousey right now. I don't want to talk about the Four Horsewomen or anything like that. I don't. It's a pro wrestling show.
You want to stay positive?
Let's stay positive. You know how I feel about that. But this week we do have the Elimination Chamber coming up, as you said.
Yes.
Give me a breakdown. What are we looking at? We have Bo Dallas and Neville, which is going to be a good match. It came out of nowhere, but you put two guys that can work together in a match, and you let them have a wrestling match. I feel like I heard that before.
Yeah. Well. They should have a good match. I think and they're going to have two Elimination Chamber matches, right?
Correct, yeah. The tag team title and the Intercontinental title.
Right, so there's six teams in the tag team match, and then six guys in the Intercontinental title match, which are the same six guys that seem to always fight for the Intercontinental title. So
I could close my eyes and tell you that Wade Barrett's going to be in every single Intercontinental title match from now until 2018.
And Dolph Ziggler,
right. Yeah.
And Rusev. Rusev's in this one, actually. That's kind of new for him, right? He hasn't been in the IC title hunt because he's been in the U.S. title hunt for a very long time.
Correct. Rusev, I mean... There's a feud going into that with Rusev and Ziggler,
right.
And congratulations to Rusev on his move from Russia
to Bulgaria.
To Bulgaria.
Yeah.
I looked it up before, it was 1,400 miles.
Yeah.
Must have been a big move in three days.
You think he used a U-Haul?
I think he might have, yeah.
Went back to Bulgaria on a U-Haul?
Yeah, probably. He came out with the flag, and now he's all anti-Lana, and they got into it, and then Lana made out with Dolph Ziggler like seven times, who's looking more and more like a rocker. Like the 1986 Rockers. Yeah. Okay. I love the jean jacket. He looks like he was in Whitesnake. I love Whitesnake. I want to get somebody new. I mean, it's cool to have, I guess, Rusev in there, but what can he really do in the Elimination Chamber?
I don't know. Same thing he always does, I guess. He's just, you know, he'll beat up some people and maybe he'll eliminate one or two guys. And I don't see him winning the match, do you? I feel like, I mean, I wouldn't have any problem if he did, but I don't see him winning.
No, I wouldn't have any problem whatsoever, but I feel like him and Dolph Ziggler may counter each other out because they can continue their own feud, and we're going to have another Wade Barrett.
Seems like a Sheamus issue. It feels like a Sheamus issue.
God, I forgot.
You almost forgot about Sheamus.
I can never forget about Sheamus. Who do you think walks away with the title after that?
After the sixth person?
After the sixth person.
I'm thinking Sheamus is going to walk out with it. I don't see R-Truth getting it, as much as I know you've been clamoring for the R-Truth push.
I have been.
To the top.
What's up? Yeah,
I don't see him getting it. I think Ziggler's had it a ton of times. I think Barrett's already had it a ton of times.
It's going to do nothing for either of those guys. I think you're right.
And I think Rusev's, the thing with him, like you said, is the focus is more on the angle with Ziggler, so I don't see him coming out of it with it. So I think that really leaves Ryback or...
You might see Ryback with it.
Yeah. You might see me walk out of your house at that point if that happens when we watch the show. I would leave under protest.
good thing it's free. We don't have to pay like $78 to order the pay-per-view anymore. But you could give it to Rusev. But like you said, Wade Barrett and Dolph Ziggler, they don't need any more titles. They've had the title. Does the title make the man, or does the man make the title?
Well, I mean, you hope that what they're trying to do is build the title back up. So people will actually...
They were building the title back up until Daniel Bryan got injured.
Yeah, I mean, that, so now, I think that was the idea.
I think they've done a good job building the U.S. heavyweight title back up.
Yeah.
John Cena, he's putting on good matches every week. He's got the U.S. Open Challenge. Mm-hmm. There's a reason for his matches.
Until Kevin Owens stepped on it.
Kevin Owens stepping on the title, raising the NXT title was great. Mm-hmm. But all right, so you're going to say Sheamus.
I'm going Sheamus.
I want to be different, and I'm going to say R-Truth walks away with the title. And a swerve. No, I'm a Rusev. Rusev is going to win the title this week.
Okay. Yeah, no, I could see Rusev doing it. I mean, that's fine. I mean, I think I'd be okay with you. Well... I'm not really sure that I'm okay with Sheamus, but at this point, I'm just accepting it.
I like Sheamus as a heel. He's come back as a heel. He's been a lot stronger. Yeah. So That leads us to the other Elimination Chamber match with the six right. person. I've watched wrestling since I was 4 years old. I cannot tell you who is in this tag team match. There's so many tag team. I don't understand what they're trying to do. I know you have Kid and Cesaro. You mm-hmm. have the New Day. You've got mm-hmm. the Lucha Dragons.
Yep, that's three.
You've got the guys, the Bull.
The Matadors.
Los Matadors.
Come on.
You've got the Primetime Players yep. and...
Your team.
My team. I have so many teams. Red Dragon? Is Red Dragon in the match? No. Who's the other one?
The Ascension, right?
Oh, and the Ascension, right. We just touched on the Ascension.
Not Harper and Rowan, who just got back together, right?
No.
We can't have them in the match.
Why would you put the two guys that are the most over that could wrestle
in the
match?
Well, they're really featuring the Matadors feud with the Bull. I think they're going to break that loose pretty soon.
It's been a long time since they've had a feud with
It's like the Horsemen and Dusty back in the 80s. That's really...
Yeah, it reminds me of the Tully Blanchard Magnum T.I. Quit match. Such passion for a little bull.
And they're going to break the bull's arm in a car door or something like that. I think that's the next thing.
Love the storytelling behind the bull. What do you think? Pin the tail on the donkey.
I'm booking it for him.
You're going to book it for him? Yeah. We're going to book that match?
Yeah.
I want to see Kid and Cesaro get the title back, which means there's literally no chance in the holiest of hell that's going to happen.
Seems like it's... If they're really going to run with the New Day thing, I think they're just going to keep it on them.
It seems, yeah, I agree.
Right? They're trying to make them like super annoying, which they're doing a good job of that.
Yeah, I have no problem with the New Day. Yeah, I don't like them taking. Fine. I have no problem with the New Day, but I don't like them taking the titles off of Kid and Cesaro.
Yeah, I thought that was too soon, but I think they just kind of felt that New Day was getting some steam as like a new team that was getting over and getting some heat from the crowd. And they're like, oh, I'll just shift it to these guys because Cesaro and Kid were heels at first too, and then they kind of got over.
Well, look at the pop
side.
They got every single week they come out. Cesaro and Kid are those are the guys everybody cheers. But who cares what the people think? It's about what Vince McMahon thinks. At the end of the day,
he's gonna get us thrown off the air. Right?
Vince McMahon is that he's tweeting us right now. He's tweeting at NY Enforcer. Second plug. That's also my Instagram. If you guys are bored on the internet, anyway,
on social media.
Social media. So. I'd like to see Kid and Cesaro win it, but I don't see it happening. I know they're high on the Lucha Dragons. Maybe the Lucha Dragons.
Yeah, I like those guys' matches too. I mean, they're
at least these guys seem like these are guys that should be in Elimination Chamber. You're gonna get more out of it. You're gonna get more spots with it. It's gonna be a faster pace as compared to the IC title match, which I don't have very many high hopes for.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure it'll be the standard thing. Like Ziggler will do a bunch of crazy spots, right, and do some crazy stuff,
some bumps on the steel on the outside.
Yeah, I think
very
that's
very Shawn Michaels-esque, and him and Rusev, like I said, will continue that. But
I think that's generally where that's gonna go. I mean, so it'll be fine. Just like they just had a 6 or 7 guy ladder match at WrestleMania,
right?
With, like,
and
a
they
lot of
they
the
also
guys.
Just had like a 10-on-3 match this week with the tag team titles, and last week they had like the 3-on-3 with the tag.
So they're getting everybody involved.
It's just gonna be a cluster of spot after spot after spot after spot, and then the last match. Is this main eventing? Or is
I assume it's well, we talked about Cena and Owens already, so we went through that, and then it's the WWE Championship match, which is Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose. So they finished that angle last night on Raw, where the whole deal was he had to sign the contract for the match by the end of the night. They ended up getting him arrested. They had the whole...
He had Will Ferrara from Ring of Honor in there as a cameraman.
Yes, very Stone Cold, like, angle, right, from, like, the late
90s. And then he came
he comes
back
driving
the
paddy wagon.
Sure.
And signs the contract at the end of the night with some help from Roman Reigns. So, I mean, those guys fought a bunch last summer.
Yeah, and they have good matches.
And, they have good matches. They had a good feud. I think they're just sort of... this is a short time frame between major pay-per-view
now, those
shows.
But those are two guys that I would like to see build like a strong feud around instead of just being like, oh, we have nothing for the title picture. Let's throw Dean Ambrose in, who is consistently, again, he's the most over every week.
I think that's kind of what it is now, right? Like, he's kind of like, I don't want to say he's the new Daniel Bryan because they're not the same guy, but in some senses, they're like, oh, this is a guy that the crowd really likes that we really didn't intend for the crowd to really like.
This guy
so we're
worked
stick him
his
in these
way
matches.
Up to, yeah, exactly.
We're going to put him in these matches because we know it'll be good anyway, but we have no intention of having him actually win the title. And
how many years in a row can you do that until you're like, all right, well, we got to give him the title before the internet explodes?
Well, they did it
with,
Bryan. Yep. So, I mean, maybe they'll do it with Ambrose at some point. I mean, that would be cool. But I feel like that's what this is. Like, they just kind of threw this pay-per-view out of nowhere a couple weeks ago and like, oh, we're going to have this show, Elimination Chamber, out of nowhere. And
that's the
now
beauty
we need
of
a
having the network.
And,
you could do that with the network and all of a sudden. Like, it's like a Saturday night's main event 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Now, that's what they're doing with it.
So I think that's why they stuck Ambrose in that spot. But I mean, and we've talked about it, obviously, off air before, but I mean, I think Ambrose is a guy that's, like I said, he's gotten over organically with the crowd. Like, they didn't, I don't think it's because WWE pushed him. It's because they like him and his work and his gimmick and his interviews.
They give
and
him a little
like
bit of freedom to talk. And
yeah, so I think the people really like genuinely like him, as opposed to like the Roman Reigns style push, which is the we're going to tell you that you like this guy.
You have to like Roman Reigns.
He's going to be in the main event.
Roman Reigns is America. You don't like America? That's the kind of thing.
Yeah. Like, so I think that's, you know, it's cool to see Ambrose at least get the opportunity to main event for the title. So
quick pick, Ambrose or Tyler Black. Who walks away?
I don't see.
Rollins.
Yeah, I don't see any way Rollins doesn't walk out the title, especially since he's done like two jobs, at least, if not three, that I forgot
about
to Ambrose.
Again, your favorite angle with a guy who's a champion.
My pet peeve.
He get the champion gets pinned in a tag team match.
Yeah,
brutal every single time.
Well, I just don't like the champion getting pinned at all. Like, I think that needs to be saved for special occasions because it means something. But the thing is, like,
remember
Rollins
that time Hulk Hogan lost in a non-title match at Tuesday Night in Texas? No, I don't either, Joe.
It's very rare. Like, it was very rare back in the day, and I think that's what makes champions strong. Like, I know you hate Brock Lesnar, but
first Ronda Rousey and Brock. Let's dedicate an entire segment to Ryback and see how hot you get.
It's topical, bro.
It's not topical.
It's topical.
All right,
but he was a guy that obviously he wasn't on TV every week because of the whole situation with like the dates
right.
to work and everything. But he didn't lose.
And even when he lost, he didn't lose.
He didn't lose. So like he's a strong, you know, champion. He's a strong
people believe
character.
Brock Lesnar's a legitimate badass. And if somebody's gonna come in and beat Brock Lesnar, they're gonna be the guy.
Yeah.
It's not gonna be just they're not gonna have me walk in and beat Brock Lesnar.
Right. And then they switch the title to Rollins.
I would beat Brock Lesnar. No?
I believe in you.
As long as I have the power of the four horsemen behind me. Yeah. They switch the title to Rollins and he's just jobbing every week. They're making him look weak because he's got the authority and he's got the J&J security. I love those guys. So you're going Rollins? I agree with you. I'm going to go with Rollins too. And is Roman Reigns doing anything?
I don't
at the pay-per-view.
Think he's got a match signed right now. And then Orton hasn't been on TV, so they don't have him on it.
Bray
I guess
Wyatt
maybe,
doesn't have.
Yeah, maybe they're going to give those chamber matches a lot of time because I think there's only like four or five matches signed for the show. I mean, or they're going to
also we have SmackDown taping tonight, so maybe they add. I foresee them adding Reigns versus Kane because they had a couple of week after week after
that
week.
That makes sense. And I mean, they probably need to add at least one or two more matches, so I'm sure that's what they're going to do. And
Divas match? Is there? Are we going to see Candice LeRae and Joey Ryan versus Monster Mafia?
I didn't see that booked, but I'll check back during the course of the week.
Add Joey Ryan on Instagram. We could find out.
He'll
know what to do. Joey Ryan, the world's cutest tag team. So this week we have we've got the Elimination Chamber on Sunday. Anything else going on this week you can think of?
Well, I mean, yeah, the other stuff I think is the major shows coming up are kind of being built to, like, obviously we're big
talk about
Ring of
Honor.
Yeah.
Huge last week, if anybody gets a chance to watch Ring of Honor, it was Jay Lethal versus Kyle O'Reilly in an awesome, awesome match. I'm not gonna spoil the end, but I think that was a great way to get heat on Jay Lethal too.
Yeah, it's one of the feuds that I guess one of the major feuds that they've been building towards for the pay-per-view
what's,
in June.
Wait, what's building a feud? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Is that? I haven't seen that. What is that? Is that when there's like a storyline and people get emotionally invested in it?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the fans feel strongly one way or the other towards both guys.
Okay. Yeah. Very diplomatic. So they're building towards best in the world, which I'll say it again, but we're going to.
Yep.
Sit in front row. Best in the world.
It's not an accident.
No, it's not. You're going to have Jay Briscoe versus Jay Lethal, title versus title. One guy's going to walk around two belts, which is pretty cool. As of today, Ring of Honor announced Samoa Joe. He's not going to be at Best in the World, though, correct?
I don't think so.
Taping the night after.
Yeah, the night after they're doing a
Samoa
TV taping,
Joe and AJ Styles versus Kazarian and Daniels. Who are all four guys from TNA Impact, and it's cool to have Samoa Joe in NXT and in Ring of Honor, so I'm going to be pumped to see that.
Yep.
But focusing more on the pay-per-view, they announced The Kingdom versus the Young Bucks and AJ Styles, a.k.a. the Bullet Club.
Right.
So that's going to be a great match.
Should be awesome.
I believe Donovan Dijak versus Mark Briscoe was signed today.
Was it? Okay.
Yeah, I picked that up on the old internet. I'm an insider, Joe. I'm not just a beard and a nice mustache and a man bun. There's more to me than meets the eye. I'm really excited for that. There's going to be I'm deep. I'm philosophical. I'm emotional. I'm everything. And last week there was War Machine versus the Briscoe Brothers.
Right, on Ring of Honor TV.
Yeah. That was, by all accounts, that was an amazing match as well. So Ring of Honor TV, it's 1 hour a week on their website for free. If you're a professional wrestling fan and you like NXT or, you know, you have no reason not to watch that.
I think that's a good point about their shows because, like, that's one of the things that's a selling point for me. Like, obviously, we pretend to be adults, right? So we have jobs and stuff like that. So it's
you
hard
dress
to find
like an adult. I dress like a kid who got stuck in 1998.
It was a good year. But to find a time, right, every week to watch professional wrestling, how many hours, right? You have to watch 3 hours of Raw.
I don't have to watch 3 hours of Raw. I don't even choose to. No, we choose to fast forward through Raw. Yeah. Well, but not for nothing. You got a 3 hour show and then you have a 15 minute time overrun.
Yeah, it's a three hour plus show, right? And then 2 hours of SmackDown every week. And then if they have a pay per view, it's 3 hours. NXT's an hour. So like when you have
Hold
a show
on,
like Ring of Honor,
I have a personal life. I don't have time. I've got nothing. All I do is watch wrestling.
But for people that do,
yeah,
it's
true.
Hard.
That's
I'm sure
true.
To watch all this wrestling. So for Ring of Honor, it's an alternative, right? It's different.
And you get more wrestling in 1 hour than you will get in 3 hours of Raw.
Yeah, it's a
and
different
presentation. That's not me knocking Raw. That's legitimate. If you time the matches and you time it out, you're going to see a lot more professional wrestling.
Sure. Yeah,
Michael
Elgin
versus Caprice Coleman from last week was the best wrestling match I saw all week, but, you know, until I saw Jay versus Kyle O'Reilly. It was much better than anything on Raw.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the thing. It's a different presentation. It's a different, like, group of people that they're targeting. So, like, some people might not like to watch as much wrestling. They might be more for the sports entertainment
wait,
stuff.
Wait, what?
The 10-year-olds.
Okay. People don't like to watch wrestling?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe the kids. I don't know. I don't all know right. what they're into these days.
I got hot. Yeah.
Yeah, a lot.
Yeah. Pro wrestling is real. People are fake. Ken Anderson shirt said that.
So, but yeah, I mean, I guess my point was that to watch Ring of Honor for like 50 minutes every week is not a big deal. And it's not a lot to do. And I can kind of just do it while I'm eating breakfast on like a Saturday.
Do it on
something.
Your cell phone at work too. You could do that too. If you have free Wi-Fi.
I don't know if I'd advise people to be watching wrestling while they're at work.
Anyway, don't watch it on your cell phone then. But no,
I mean, because neither of us do that.
Yeah, I don't do that if anybody's listening. Candace, I'm just kidding. But just, you know, it's a different atmosphere too because it's so focused on the wrestling. It's not focused on Hornswoggle and, you know, the Bull and El Torito and whatnot.
Yeah, there's less silly angles. I mean, they have some things that are kind of a little goofy sometimes, like romantic touch and things of that nature. But, I mean, it's most of it is pretty seriously presented wrestling matches and feuds. So... And it's a little bit old school in that regard if you're looking for, like, you know, stuff from, like, I don't know, NWA in the 80s or
I was
going to
say, there's
be.
A lot of, it gets gruesome, you know, there's a lot of storytelling, but there's continuity, and there's a reason for the matches. And sometimes it's not a reason, and you should have two guys that can wrestle, like, put on a good 15, 20-minute match, and then something will develop from there, whether it be an angle or whatnot, but wrestling is the focus.
And I think the characters, like, of the wrestlers are, at least to me, it feels like, is their own... like creations, right? Like Adam Cole. Like Jay Briscoe is Jay Briscoe. Like WWE, it's more like, okay, we're telling, you know, Ryback to be Ryback, or we're telling Bray Wyatt to be Bray Wyatt. Like, and it, sometimes it feels a little forced because maybe...
Well, that's why ECW was so popular because, you know, Paulie used to give them the creative freedom and they said, hey, you have 10 minutes, go cut a promo. The guy's not going to all of a sudden turn into a magical dragon that turns people into hobbits, you know? Right. He's going to go out there and cut the promo on things that are topical to him and then he's passionate about. And that's what I want to watch. You know, I don't want to watch some forced... gimmick, like anything.
Yeah, it feels more realistic.
That's why I like Neville. You know, Neville is who he is. He doesn't have a ridiculous gimmick, a ridiculous attitude, and he just goes in the ring and he has good matches. Same with Ziggler, but there are some things that are just, like you said, they just feel forced and they don't feel legitimate. Whereas, you know, guys like Kyle O'Reilly, Bobby Fish, we talk about all the time. Even Jay Lethal, he took that gimmick and he ran with it. You know, they gave him a little bit, they made him Black Machismo and they made him in TNA and they made him be the new Randy Savage, but you know, they just, there's a lot more freedom to be who you are. And then also, because in Ring of Honor, you have to continue that gimmick. If you're not exclusive to Ring of Honor, you to other independents, to, you know, PWG or, to, you know, FWE, you are who you are. You don't have a gimmick that, you can't be one gimmick here and then you go to Florida and you're somebody else. You're that person the entire time. So.
Yeah, those guys, I guess, you know, that's how they earn a living, right? Is going around to different promotions and working these matches or whatever it is. And that's how they make, that's
how
they make
their
money.
Do you think we could make a living going around to different places and podcast? Like a Sweet 16 or something? You think people want us?
Sweet 16? Like a bar mitzvah or something?
A bar mitzvah, yeah.
I mean, I don't see why not.
We have a future in this, right?
Yeah.
I'm pumped about it. I feel good
about it. At least we think so.
At least we think. And that's really all that matters for our one listener out there.
There you go.
Well, it's too sweet for the one listener.
There it is.
Too sweet for our new social media team. We're looking at you. We see you.
So I think there was one other match, right, for the Ring of Honor pay-per-view. It's the triple threat for the number one contender spot. It's Roderick Strong, Moose, and Michael Elgin. I think those are the other. That's the only one. The other one I know that's signed for the show.
You're not just triceps, Joe. You bring a lot more to the table. I completely forgot about that match. They just signed Moose to a long term deal, so I feel like
His contract was coming up. I think this summer, so they re-signed him. So I mean, I don't know if that necessarily means he's going to win or lose, but at least that means
he's definitely gotten so much better. Yeah. He's working hard, and Roderick Strong's always going to be there. And who's the other one?
Michael Elgin.
Elgin, right. They're pushing him too. That could be a good match.
The other thing, I guess, not that I'm trying to make Ring of Honor out to be the best thing in the world, but
they have a pay-per-view called Best in the World.
That's true. I actually don't know who's going to win those matches. Like, I couldn't tell you today, like, that I definitively know. Like, we just went through the Elimination Chamber show.
And we can pretty much book it ourselves.
You can pretty much figure out, like, who's going to win. Like, Rollins is probably going to keep the title in the main event, like, that type of thing. Like, I don't really know. Like, I would probably think Jay Briscoe is going to win, but... He might not. Like, I could see Lethal winning. I can, and then, like, whoever wins that, you know, maybe you can base that off of who wins in a more contender spot, like, or, you know, who's going to fight at the next show, big show. So there's a lot of, like, uncertainty, and I think that adds an extra element to the matches also when you think about, okay, well, I don't know who's
going to
win this.
So the false finishes and the close falls, like, actually has, you know, me up my... When you watched Red Dragon versus the Young Bucks 2 out of 3 falls match, we were both going crazy because we had no idea who was going to win that match.
Sure.
So yeah, what Ring of Honor brings to the table, too.
The last pay-per-view we went to was Final Battle in December.
Remember when I started crying when Kushida had the Kimura on Kyle O'Reilly?
Yeah.
I was for sure thought he was going to tap out.
The whole arena looked at you.
But anyway, Kyle O'Reilly, no, you're right, though. I'm like, those matches and all three of those guys, they were pushing Roderick Strong for a while. It's like, you really don't know. But the good thing about it is you could throw any three of those guys into the main event picture or into a title match with Jay Lethal or Jay Briscoe, and they're going to put on a good match. So I'm okay with any outcome.
Yeah. I mean, it's shaping up so far to be another good show. And I'm glad that we're going to be sitting first row. Did we talk about that?
We mentioned sitting front row. Okay. And the very last thing before we wrap up, this Sunday, Evolve. I'll talk about it every single week because they're going to be there. Evolve and Ronkonkoma.
Yeah, Evolve Pro
Roderick
Wrestling.
Strong versus Drew Galloway in the main event. Yeah. Who else?
Featuring such other stars as...
Davey Richards versus Drew Gulak.
Tony Nese is going to be there, right?
Tony Nese,
Caleb Conley, Trevor Lee, Mike Bailey.
Speedball Mike, Biff Busick.
Biff Busick, yeah.
Yeah, the whole card is awesome.
SoCal Val.
SoCal Val. You and SoCal Val have a thing. I remember you met her twice, and I remember.
If by thing you mean... I look at her Twitter every day, then yes, that's a thing.
That's actually exactly what I meant. Mm-hmm. But that's going to be an awesome show. It's on iPay-Per-View, and the website is dgusa.com.
Yeah, it's DragonGateUSA.com. Dragon Gate is how it falls under, yeah.
And if you go to their YouTube page, they have tons of awesome matches to watch. So
yeah.
This Sunday, Ronkonkoma, go to it.
Yeah, very affordable, right? It's like 30, 40 bucks for a ticket at most.
$30 for sitting second row, and you get a $10 voucher.
Merch cred.
I don't have enough pro wrestling t-shirts.
You need
to further prove I'm an established adult in life. All I have is a
Chris
closet
Hero
full.
Attire.
I do.
You need.
I have a closet full of professional wrestling t-shirts. But anything else? That's it, professional
and
wrestling.
That covers it for the next week. It's going to be good, man. You know, we got, like I said, you got Evolve coming up on Sunday.
Yep.
Elimination Chambers this Sunday.
Maybe we could post a video at Evolve. I think people, they've heard me talk about your arms, but I think they want to see them in real life. You know,
okay.
That means we need some pre-workout.
I mean,
we
think it's
going
to bring, you know, views to the page.
More than... We have one consistent listener. I feel like it could bring a couple.
So you think it's going to branch it out?
We're going to branch out.
Well, you're the idea man behind us, so.
I'm the idea, you're the good looks and everything
else.
I'm
just the guy that puts the stuff on the internet, and that's it.
All right, until next time.
All right, see you soon, buddy.
Great job, pal.